Hey everyone, it's Ben Hardy here, and in today's video we're going to be going over a Land Rover Defender Trek Edition. This is actually a super special limited edition, but first and foremost, a huge shout out and thank you to the Land Rover of Downtown Salt Lake for giving me some time with this Trek Edition. Now this is just going to be a quick walk around with the Trek Edition. They're actually going to do some changes to this vehicle, and then I'm going to review it again where I'm actually going to drive and all that fun stuff. But I also want to give a shout out to Zane at the Land Rover dealership. He actually sent me some footage of him taking this Trek Edition off-road. We're gonna have that at the start of the video, then we're gonna go over the walk around. And so yeah, with all that being said, let's just get right into it.
Yeah,
crank it to the left.
Because you catch yourself right in the pillar here, so turn towards me, come up towards me, and then perfect.
Yeah.
Almost.
So let's go over this Trek Edition Land Rover Defender. And first off, I want to mention that this actually has the 2.0 in it, which is still a good powertrain. It's good for 296 horsepower, 295 pound-feet of torque. But you guys can see the cable there that I am pointing at. This thing is decked out. So you guys can see there, you've got the Trek there on the center right there. And if you guys are wondering, it's something that Land Rover does every single year. And now that they have the Defender, that's the one that they're taking out. And you can see the protection there on the front. And then down below, you've got a lot of stock stuff from like a stock Defender. We do have a light bar there in the center, which would obviously help with off-roading at night. And then you actually get a winch here in the front. It's a worn winch. And if I remember correctly, it does have a synthetic cable, which is the way to go, because if you do synthetic cable and it snaps for some reason, that is going to be a lot safer than if you do the old steel cable, because that's how you get hurt pretty bad. But anyways, notice that you've got the steel wheels here on the Trek Edition, and then you guys can see 255 millimeter tires wrapped around, well, 18 inch steel wheels. And I think it looks so cool. It has that old school off-roader type look, and I love it. And then, yes, of course, we've got the snorkel, because, well, you can't do the off-roading with that one. It looks cool. And then you get the lights there at the top again. That's going to help with nighttime off-roading. Looks great too. And then notice how the mirror is gloss black. And then again, you've got the Trek stickers, and it's, well, out in North Carolina, that's why it says that. I think it's so cool that Land Rover does that for the dealerships and everything, that they take people out to take them off-road so that they can learn more about the product they sell. But anyways, notice the door handles aren't wrapped like the rest of the car. It is a wrap, by the way, if you guys were wondering. And then you've got the mud flap there in the rear, but the front doesn't have one. So I thought that was interesting, so I pointed it out. And then you guys can see right here all of the stuff on the side. And then notice that those names are the people that got to go out and take this Defender off-road, which is pretty cool. And then you have the ladder up to the top, which again gives you that old school like Land Rover theme. I just imagine this thing just cruising through Africa. That's what I imagine this doing. And then you got the spare tire, which notice it actually has a cover over it. Again, it's kind of like an old school off-road SUV thing, which I think is really cool, and still functions the same. Now, I do need to mention, this literally just arrived that same day that I filmed it, and so it still has a bunch of stuff in it from the whole Trek thing, but I thought that you guys would want to see what this is set up like when they do this Trek. So you've got a bunch of tires in the back of it, which is pretty awesome. And then this one does have the air suspension, so that's why it can raise and lower there in the rear. We've got a full power outlet back there. But yeah, we've got a bunch of tires in the back. And don't worry, that stuff was all taken out. But I figured you guys would kind of want to see behind the scenes of when something like this pops into a dealership, because it's a very unique thing. And then you guys can see the two exhaust tips there at the back, and then the receiver hitch. And then notice the design there on the mud flap itself, which looks great. And if you guys are wondering, that's the place that did the off-road stuff. It's Lucky's Off-Road Equipment. And then you guys know I'm a huge fan of what they've done with the new Defender, with the door panel. Looks great. And then you guys can see the rest of the equipment sitting here in the back. So also, I guess, back seat's kind of full, so you can't really have back passengers with all that stuff. But notice there's coverings on the seats. So the seats already have the plastic on it that protects it, but these coverings kind of do as a double thing to, like, double protect it. So you really... like, it's impossible to damage something. So I think that's cool. And then obviously this one before the wrap is black. If you guys were wondering, if you notice with the door, opening that up with a door jam, was originally a black Defender. And then again, all the storage here on the side, again, just looks so cool. This is one of the coolest, it was the coolest Defender I've seen, if you ask me. And then we got the shovels and stuff at the top, because, you know, when you're off-roading, just in case you get stuck, you gotta be able to, you know, dig yourself out. So it's cool that it comes with all of that on the top rack. And then you guys can see normal door panel here at the front of the Trek Edition. And then notice here, we've got the two extra gas cans, so you can take some extra fuel with you, so you get a little bit of extra range, right, while you're doing your off-road adventures and all that fun stuff. But going from that to the driver's side, which somehow I teleported, magical, right? Magic of editing. Notice there's a camera there on the side of the mirror, and then it's got blind spot monitoring as well. But you guys can see the door panel here at the front with all the exposed rivets. Just looks amazing. I love it. The more I see the new Defender, the more I'm a fan. And then notice the seats at the front also have the covers on them to protect them, so that if you get them super dirty off-road, you don't have to worry about damaging the seat or anything. Then also cleanup's easier as well. And then you guys can see the pedal layout, all that fun stuff, and then the floor mats, everything there to protect all of it. And then you got some auxiliary switches for the lights, for example. And then you guys can see all of that's the same. So, like, it still has an infotainment system, still has, like, all the regular drive mode select, climate control select. So even though this is a crazy off-road SUV, it has all that stuff. And then look at the design around the shifter area. And then notice that it tells you it's a Trek Edition. It gives you the number on it. This one's 21 of 70. There's only 70 worldwide. That's it. Super limited edition vehicle. And then you guys can see the center console there with the wireless phone charger at the front end. And yeah, this is kind of a basic tour. Like I said at the beginning of the video, I'm going to try to get to the Land Rover dealership before this thing sells, so I can get another review on it and drive it and tell you guys how this thing actually drives. I think that's something that you would all be pretty interested in. But I thought it'd be cool for you guys to see behind the scenes with, like, at a dealership, to see a car as it, you know, comes in from something like this. It's a super unique event with a car manufacturer, which again, I thought was pretty cool. But I want to show you guys another Defender. This one's a stock one. Just give you guys an idea of how crazy this thing actually is, because when you just look at just that, you're like, oh, cool, kind of decked out Defender, whatever. But then you see the stock one, you're like, okay, yeah, thing's pretty crazy. It, like, pops out, like, it stands out so much. Super unique. Like, just look at the and this one's black, which is perfect. So, like, this is pretty much what that Defender looked like before the Trek package was put on it. So you guys can imagine, like, they changed a lot to make it look like what the Trek looks like. So you have, like, that, right? That's you, okay? I got to make this joke in this video, because I always got to make this joke. That's that Defender represents you, and then the Trek Edition is the guy she tells you not to worry about. Yeah, it's just crazy how it looks. I'm a huge fan. And then also, here's the key fob, because I forgot to show it earlier. It's got a regular key fob. So, like, even though it has all this crazy stuff, like I said, it's a Defender. Functions just like any other Defender would. That's a Trek Edition. I love it. Now let's get some things up going over this Land Rover Defender Trek Edition. Again, a huge shout out to Zane at the Land Rover dealership, and then obviously the Land Rover of downtown Salt Lake. Check out their inventory in the description down below. I'll see all of you in the next video.